Hello. I will figure this out eventually. That is not even the right god. Hello. I am here, and I am alive. Today, we are going to drink some tea. We are going to spend some time somewhere in Destiny. Right. So, here are the things that I'm kind of behind on. I haven't done my pinnacle run of prophecy, but I did that last not too long ago. I also haven't done Shattered Throne. I could also do Blind Well. I could also continue my attempts at Spire of the Watcher, though that has never gone well. Or I could try this. Because I'm working on doing this on Legend because I have four quests that need to do that. And I think my light level is, or our power level is getting close. To where that might not be a massive problem. Yeah, if I take shotgun, Wishender, that's 18, 18, 18. I don't think I have a higher level here. I can potentially boost my boots up one. Like, I kind of need to grind some gear, technically. And one way to do that is just to. Oh, what's a weekly mission? Alright. And pestilence, overcharged weapons. Yeah, I could do this. I don't remember which ones break out. Or breakneck. Yeah, I could do that. Let's do that and see how that goes. Long-ish, close-ish, close, close. This is when we learn, don't know how to play Solar Warlock well.
So, going directly after Talus kind of blew up in our faces. We need to be looking at the bigger picture. We want to protect the Veil. We first and foremost need to protect the Cloud Arc.
Rohan, I think we're still a little fuzzy here. What exactly is the Cloud Arc?
It's our city's network. Our infrastructure. Our people. Our defenses. Everything depends on it.
And what we're doing now is stopping the Vex from siphoning energy from the Cloud Arc's reactor. If we do that, the Veil's safe, then the Amuni are safe. Bing, bang, boom. Starter is on Rohan.
Make your way to the Cloud Arc reactor. We'll head to the central power junction. Once you cycle the system, we'll be able to return power to the reactor.
Well, fuck you too, Cyclops. Yeah, this is gonna be slow moving. That was a failure. And I think I'm gonna keep accepting failure. And return to orbit. Don't die before I can hold that button. Oh, right. I wanted to confirm this. This was Season of the Seraph. I have a quest to finish this. So we're gonna finish this, because we can. And...
To understand where we are today, there's only one place to start. Cade 6. Cade 6 was the Hunter Vanguard, a mentor to every hunter in the tower. He was an infamous daredevil, a dependable fireteam member, and our dear friend. He never missed a chance to make light of the situation, even in dark times. Our responsibilities weighed on all of us. He tried his best to ease that burden. Cade's final mission was to prevent a breakout at the Prison of Elders in the Reef. Things didn't go as planned.
So if I remember this correctly, from what I've heard, this mission is not Nathan Fillion's dialogue. Oh wow, they skipped.
The Prison of Elders held some of the most dangerous bows ever encountered. With the security
they skipped the entire cool part of this.
To prevent them from ravaging all of Sol. Petravenge, right hand of the Awoken Queen. Reached out to Cade and the Guardians for help getting things back under control.
This is the security hub. Better clear the area before going in.
Yeah, game, I don't need a tutorial. I have been playing this game for a while. I didn't think you fought Scorn this early.
They used to be foes.
Timing as usual. All that's left is to turn it off.
Like, one of Destiny's biggest problems is that they keep having to sunset stuff. though having is a bit of a strong turn of phrase, or a mostly self-inflicted injury.
I've got struck. Now, remember to purge the buffers.
Sure, got it. One question? How do I do that?
Press the red button.
They're all red!
Then press all of them.
I can't believe that worked! I am amazing at this.
Scratch that. It did not work. Don't worry, we got this! With extreme prejudice. Well, everything's where it's supposed to be, but now it's asking me for some kind of secondary activation.
Should be a terminal you can use out on the catwalks. I'd go with you, but I hear this place has turrets, and I really want to fire it. By the way, you and me, good team.
Let me get that door for you.
Oh, the turrets have a manual mode. Interesting.
Hey, buddy, what do you think of my new gun?
You still with us, Petra? We're gonna clear you a path to Supermax real soon.
Copy that.
Oh, I could get used to this!
Don't mind me, just shooting shit. That's convenient that this door is half open.
Bringing the security system online.
Looks like we're all done and dusted here, kiddos. Ramen's on me.
Looking pretty good down here. Just gotta check one last thing.
Yeah, this game looks really good. Visually, this is one of my... This game works really well visually to make something that looks coherent and unified. Almost nothing looks out of order.
Cade, he's gone. This isn't a prison riot. It's a prison break.
The airlock on Deck Zero. It's the only way out this far down. They're going to escape.
Not if I get there first.
Yeah, like, this is an act of hubris. I love that Petra's just mouthing, "What the fuck?" It's like, why would you do something so stupid, Cade? I'm doing something stupid? That sounds exactly like me.
Spectacular landing. And cue the ominous music.
And here we see the villains for this expansion.
Okay, everybody. Back in your cages.
The Scorn. One of the villains.
I said, back in your cages!
And like, a really elegantly... I love how this really feels. Like, this is Cade playing with the entire Hunter toolkit in a cinematic fashion rather than a gameplay fashion, which is really cool to see. Blade Barrage.
That's it. Now I'm pissed. Oh, is that really all you got?
Thank you.
Petra? What's happening down there? Come in, Cade. Hey, welcome back. We fell at least 20 stories down, and I can't reach Cade or Petra. Cade must be further down. There's a hatch over there.
Like, I'm... The abominations are the one part of the... like, one type of Scorn unit I don't fully understand. Because everything else is a variation on Elixir.
This is awkward. You got a gun I can borrow?
No. But I do have a bullet with your name on it.
Any second now, my partner is gonna roll in here and kill every last one of you. And you, my man.
This is going to hurt. Any last words?
How's your sister?
But yeah, that's how Cade dies. Aldern Solv, the prince of the Forsaken, the Forsaken prince. Cast out of his homeland. Found meaning. By saving a Scorn or a fallen Archon.
To Aldrin, Cade was just an obstacle in his path. But to us, the loss of Cade was devastating. It shattered our fire team and left the last city in mourning. Aldrin met his fate, but that wasn't the end of his story. He was resurrected by a ghost named Glint, and having no memory of his past, took on the name Crow. At first, the Vanguard tried to keep Crow in the dark about his past life and Aldrin's crimes. But Crow is not Aldrin. In time, we grew to understand that who someone chooses to be is more important than who they were.
So, that's our summary of everything up to Witch Queen? Okay, so we do Stasis instead, the opening mission for Europa, which is still in the game. unlike the campaign for Forsaken. But yeah, like, why does Bungie sunset so much shit? Like, I have never played on Io or Mercury, except for that brief time where I played D2 before really playing D2.
The arrival of the Black Fleet sparked great turmoil in the last city. Many of our people feared that a second collapse was imminent. The Witness took advantage of that fear. It promised power to all those worthy of it, in the form of stasis, setting off a race to Europa. We could never have imagined what awaited us on that frozen moon. We had always believed darkness itself to be inextricably linked with our enemy. Its power, a path to inevitable violence and grief. But there were those, like Elsie Bray, who understood that what we call darkness is a neutral force. Like the light, it could be a powerful tool for good in the right hands. If we were brave enough to question our beliefs.
Yeah, I want to get these quests out of my quest log.
By communing with the crux of darkness, we could learn to wield the power of stasis. First, we had to fight our way into Rhys Reborn, Aramis's stronghold on Europa.
This pyramid granted darkness to the Guardians and the Fallen. It gives power to our enemies as easily as it gives power to us. I don't trust it.
But yeah, why are there Vex on the path to Rhys Reborn? Like, this area just has never made sense why there are Vex to me.
The darkness is a neutral force, but the pyramids have an agenda. Until we know what it is, we can't let our guard down.
Gender language much? I could take your NB I could take your siblings. Oh, fucking cloaks. Yeah, Aramis is a really good villain. I like...
Aramis's presence on Europa is not happenstance. Temptation set the wheels in motion, but obsession propelled her here. To destroy the light with an army of darkness,
She and her followers make those selfish choices moment to moment. Humanity relies on our selfless acts to bring about a better world. Darkness is no more than a tool with which we do so.
Yeah, we got one of these missions, and all of the new subclass unlocking expansions, and I don't think I've liked one of them.
Inside us all is the strength to control darkness. We need only look inward and remember why we're here.
Well, they picked the worst fucking mission to demonstrate that.
With guidance and resolve, Guardians took up the power of stasis without succumbing to the Witness's corruption. Our understanding of the darkness expanded. Darkness is a part of our universe, a natural force. We wield it in defense of the last city.
I mean, stasis is specifically...
We challenged many of our assumptions in the days that followed. Where once we saw only eternal foes, we discovered allies against a common threat.
This was that, oh, Season of a Slicer was so good.
And amongst our closest friends, old enemies lay waiting. Hidden away in the last city, the Hive God Savathun prepared her greatest trick yet.
Making the world believe she wasn't real. Oh no, that was the devil. Making a really good expansion. Yeah, I need to figure out if I'm buying Lightfall or not. Sorry, Final Shape. Why does this give me the Judgment of Kel'Garath? I have no idea.
Oh. the many enemies arrayed against the last city, few were more dangerous than Savathun, Hive God of Cunning. We dealt with her forces in the past, but her cruelest trick was infiltrating the Vanguard itself in the guise of one of our own, the Warlock Osiris. Her scheming led to something we once believed impossible. Lucent Hive, raised by ghosts, now wielded the light against us. Our only hope was to uncover just how Savathun had stolen the light. To do that, we would have to battle our way through her throne world, a realm of illusions and deceit. With the Witch Queen involved, nothing could be taken for granted.
Our mission was to infiltrate the Throne World's apothecary and retrieve a powerful relic. Using our mastery of darkness, we could see into the relic's past and uncover the Witch Queen's secrets.
I could also do like...
We're in position. Where are we headed?
Why are they picking this mission?
In the apothecary wing. There you should find a particular shard of crystal. Before her lucent transformation, Savathun was in the custody of the Awoken, securely bound within a crystalline cell. Or so it seemed.
So this crystal is a piece of her former prison, which means it might be on her when she stole the light. Eris, we must seek out the aberrant paths. So what looks aberrant around here? How did you do that? It's like you created those platforms out of thin air.
Eris, what's the situation?
The Guardian is en route to the object in question.
Like, some of the things... Some of the changes they made don't make sense. Like, Deep Sight. By this point in the expansion was pretty well explained. Smack. I thought, anyway.
I bet this knife sword will be just as useful as the last one. We need to find a lock to smash open.
Cast her realm in a lucent sheen, but remnants of dark architecture still lurk underneath.
And the Guardian's new ability reveals these hidden remnants. Yes, Ikora explained. Why can't we use the light to achieve the same result?
The light may be a powerful force, but when dealing in illusions, it has proven insufficient. It is the mind that must bend to see the truths hidden here. Thus, darkness can show the way.
My only fear is where that way will lead us in the end.
All right, Guardian, let's focus. To find a way forward, we need a sword and something to smash with it.
Like, this is the... So... If I remember correctly, this is the third last mission? Might even be... Like, this is one of the last missions in the campaign. So, the order of events.
There's the crystal garden. Time to finish this.
Oh, you. Take some darkness.
We have to destroy its ghost.
Yeah, I know. Smashy, smashy.
This crystal could very well be the clue we've been looking for.
Cutscene! Take me home. Cutscene road.
The crystal revealed to us what we had refused to imagine. The Traveler itself granted Savathun the light. It reached out to our greatest foe and offered grace. For many, this marked a time of great uncertainty. A betrayal. Facing the truth and coming to terms with our doubts strengthened the vanguard for the fight ahead. Whatever the Traveler's motivations, in the end, we had to rely on each other.
Yeah.
Ironically, it was Savathun, Hive God of Deception, who revealed the true face of our common enemy, the voice in the darkness, and the architect of humanity's collapse, the Witness. Osiris's time under Savathun's thrall granted him a glimpse of a secret that she withheld from the Witness for centuries. A powerful artifact, known as the Veil, was hidden away on the planet Neptune. With Savathun off the board, the Witness would soon arrive to launch its assault against the Traveler. Armed with this vital secret, we now had a fighting chance.
Now, what do you give me from Lightfall, if anything? What is next on the quest step? Oh, just talk to Ikora. To get gun. Talk to human, get gun. Season of the Bloody Blah? Is that Season of the Defiant? No, it was Defiant this. Don't mind me. My Defiance. Risen. Risen was last year. Ostlinger. Whatever you say about Kallus, you can't deny that he had some kind of horrible, horrible taste in firearms. But yeah. Oh. I definitely left the activity. but I will accept your gift regardless. I left the activity several times. Okay, but this is my new favorite ghost show.
Hi there.
Yes, I will pick up good bow.
Bye. Hi.
Oh. Bye. Bye, my book. Bye, my book. And now the delivery one.
Thanks for your service.
All right. I'm all caught up on the story.
Examining the past helps put the present into perspective. It reminds me how much all of us have accomplished already, and what we might achieve in the future. There's power in the stories we tell each other, as surely as there is in light and dark. Together, we can face anything. So remember, eyes up.
I don't want to do that. That's work.
Walk in the light.
Alright. Here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to finish stuff in Europa that I never got around to doing. So our guide is going to be here, here, and here. Collect the DSC repository. Deepstone. Ferix the Loyal.
Tell me, friend.
Yeah, we're gonna go. I've been meaning to actually go visit Psychopath Clovis. Okay, I'm remembering why. Okay. Bastard. Yep. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Yeah, it's weird that they didn't do a single mission for Shadowkeep. Mainly because they wouldn't need to pick from many, because there's what, like, two actual missions in Shadowkeep? I swear one of you is supposed to drop a nuclear payload, and I'm then supposed to take that little radiation baby. No, bastards! My brain is cooking. My apartment building will not turn off the heat. It is 30 degrees in my apartment. Give. Fuck. Oh. I was supposed to pick shit up from Varix? God damn it. Alright. The good guy. God, I love skimmers. Oshawott, the... What is my ranking for Pokemon cuteness? They're up there. Oshawott is high on the cuteness scale. I don't remember what it looks like. Ah!
Hey,
Did that bastard run away from me? No. I'm gonna do exoscience. Let's stay in exoscience. At the end of this, we're going to see Jumbo. I know there's some over here. I don't know what I'm accomplishing, but I hope it's gonna get me the triumph for Bray Exoscience. So I think this is one of the things where we'll, if we read it, we'd learn that Clovis Bray's an asshole. does Monte Carlo do again? Now, am I capped at one of these per week? Alright, Verix the Loyal. You're a pain in the ass.
Perhaps one day, Elixni can live among guardians. We can have peace.
Alright.
Come close and listen.
Well, I'm going to go dip my head in a bucket of ice.
How fares the Queen's wrath?
So, perhaps I am going to let everyone go. Alright, bye everyone. Me.